Today we're going to look at some advanced layout techniques, like setting up a layout just to do playback to make your life easier when it comes to finding the video you're looking for. So now that we're in the software, we're going to take a look at use of layouts in an advanced method for playback capabilities and how you can find that video even faster by setting up a layout even prior to your playback. So we know something happened over the course of the last couple of days. We had a neighbor come over, something was taken from outside, and we want to find that video, but also export all of the video from all of the different cameras. So it's going to make sense for us to grab, especially if we have a good number of cameras, grab and create a new layout. So first thing I'm going to do is enter into the administrator mode, and I already know from all of our cameras which of the cameras it is that I'm going to need to see. So rather than jumping back and forth and hunting for the camera I'm looking for, I'm instead going to create a layout just like we did earlier on for a global layout there. And I'm gonna create a 7-camera layout because that's gonna have enough of the cameras of what I need. We go back into our servers tab and I'm going to drag them right onto the map. And I want our license plate camera. I'm also gonna want our PTZ camera in there as well. Then I'm looking for South Parking, 270 Northwest 2. Which is where the event actually happens, 270 Southwest 2. And then last couple of cameras are Southwest Parking. And last one was our Northwest Parking. There we go. So now I've got all of the different cameras because I know the event's gonna start here, drive through here, head up through here, around the front of the building, and then out through the exit because that's where the video started. So now I've created that layout. And if it's a layout that I think I'm gonna use multiple times, then I might add a west side and south or something so I know what that layout is. If you're only gonna use it the once, then you don't even need to name it. Now I'm gonna jump into playback, jump to the day, and I've cheated a little bit here. Watch one of our advanced videos on setting up bookmarks, but I've already gone through and played back the video. You can see the bookmarks on each of the different cameras showing me exactly when this vehicle was on each of the cameras that we needed to see so that I can jump through. And even now that I've bookmarked them, I can just drag over just that section of video to do an export like I show in one of the other videos for doing AVI exports. But now I've got all of the different cameras that I need to see for this event, and I can jump right to specific points in that event so that I can start the playback. And I can even jump just up to the one particular camera I want to see. Now when I double click again after seeing the event, and here's the person they're actually grabbing and taking some forks that they shouldn't have been taking. And these were actually able to be recovered because of this video. The owner of the forks were able to contact the police and they were able to track the people down, find it, and get them back before they had been scrapped, which is a great thing. Now the cameras have paid for themselves in avoiding having to buy additional equipment as well. But now that we have this layout, and this is the reason I created that layout, I can jump back to the layout. So even as this is playing on screen, if I want to see a different view like the 270 Northwest Parking, now I can jump into that and we can see all the way down on the end, there's that vehicle way, 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 way down there. But we can start the playback from there if we wanted to see from this side exactly what happened as well, and then watch the vehicle drive all the way down and through from this viewpoint at the same time. So it gives you the ability to jump back and forth in between cameras. Now as it's crossing over, I might jump back and say, all right, it's crossing through that truck, let me see them on the next camera, because I might need to have video footage of every moment this person is moving from one camera to the next. And this is where setting up layouts, even if it's just a one-time event that you're setting it up for, really comes in handy, because it makes it easy for if a police officer standing in your office, or if you're trying to export the video from multiple different cameras at a time, you can do that because now you have them all at your fingertips and you don't have to hunt and peck through them. So you can get the license plate like we did in this particular case. So this is just another way that we use layouts in order to give you better access to your video. It customizes your CMS4 software and makes it easier to find exactly what you're looking for, get the video off, and get back about your day, which is the important thing. You don't want to sit there watching cameras all day. I don't even want to sit there watching cameras all day, and I'm a camera guy. So stay tuned for more videos. We're going to show you more tips and tricks on how to get more out of your CMS4 software with your AVM NVRs.